this is the part 2 video of our parable. Let me congratulate these 5 winners who won the 50 pesos load of our free giveaway. Okay? And for today, let us continue what have we talked about the prodigal son. Previously, I emphasized to you that your life choices matter, right? Your life choices will have an impact for tomorrow. Now, let us continue reading on other verses, and let's start with verse 17. And it says that, "But when he came to himself, he said, 'How many of my father's hired servants have more than enough bread, but I perish here with hunger?' Verse 18, 'I will arise and go to my father, and I will say to him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you.'" As what you have noticed, sometimes the moment that we already realize that we are far away from God is when terrible things happen before us. So, pag na natay problema, adeserve pa, makarealize. Pero pag nagani sa kahayahay, mayuog na ay mainhan na Ginoo sa kinabuhi. So, that is the common mistake sa atoa. To continue, nag-ingon ang verse 19, "I am no longer worthy to be called by your son. Treat me as one of your hired servants." Here is what shame and guilt comes in. Mao lang ni trabaho ni Satan para sa atoa. No, the moment we dive into sin, pag nanata sa pagpakasala, isa jud nga atong ma-feel is that guilt and shame sa atoa. So, mood mangod ni ana, mahimutang hesitant, mahimutang nga Lord, grabe nakasala naman jud ko sa imuha, di na ko nimo madawat, di na ko nimo mapasaylo, di na ko nimo pasatanan. Ako to ang na-feel sa younger son. The moment nga nakasala siya, nakarealize siya sa iyahang buhat against sa iyang father, ana dayon siya guilt and shame sa iyahang kinabuhi. And in verse 20, nag-ingon dito, "And he arose and came to his father. But while he was still a long way off, his father saw him and felt compassion, and ran and embraced him and kissed him." Let us say that Jesus is the father in the story. Naitulog kagutang na ato mapansin sa heart ni Jesus. Isa dito ang, he saw you, he has compassion over you, and he accepts you. Friends, God sees you for who you are. God created you in your inward parts, as had been discussed in Psalms 139 verses 13 to 14. So he knows you igsoon. Dili ingon na aksidente ka, but God personally knows you, and he knows your needs, your desires, your struggles in life. Also, he is very compassionate. Because of his compassion, even though kapila na to siya gipasakitan, pero gipasaylo gihapon niya kapila pod, no, greater than our sins, greater than our iniquities towards him. And that moment that we come back into his arms, he is more willing to forgive us for our trespasses. That is the heart of Jesus. He is a forgiving. He is a forgiving God. And lastly, just like in that prodigal son, God is going to comfort you and accept you with open arms. He will not hesitate as long as you willfully submit unto his sovereignty once again. You see, that is just the 3 example of the heart of Jesus. He knows you, he has compassion for you, and he accepts you. In verse 21, it says that, "And the son said to him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you. I am no longer worthy to be called your son." Verse 22, "But the father said to his servants, Bring quickly the best robe and put it on him, and put a ring on his hand and shoes on his feet." Wow! Grabe! In this verse, this means that God accepted you with a full compassion and acceptance, and at the same time, he is accepting you with open arms. He is more than willing to give you a new life, to give you a new heart and a new beginning. If we only understood the grace of God in our lives, he is that kind of gracious that no matter how sinful you are, a new life is what he offers. Amen? That's it for today's video. I hope I've learned a lot in this video, since we discussed a lot of things that God is willing to give you a new life, a new beginning, the moment you will come back unto him. See you on my next video. I hope you are blessed. Have a great day. Bye-bye.